third day of Christmas, my true love sent to me three French hens,
two turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
Come gather near, Christmas is here, bells ring, we will sing, glad Noel. us to a familiar experience of Demon Balls. This is one of the universal favorites of all time. One of the first holiday season songs we all sing. Now, to show the pace, we can experience Jingle Bells as a waltz while watching our walk.
Thank you.
Now experience Jingle Bells in this tempo. Guess that hot chocolate will help you stand the cold another hour or so.
Merry Christmas.
A Merry Christmas, Miss Schaefer. My feet don't think so. I was speaking to you for Christmas morning.
Well, I guess everyone always means to, only...
I know. I even caught my wife mailing a package this morning. Merry Christmas.
A warm sweater for Aunt Margie. And a wallet for Rack. But still no slippers for Grandma yet. How am I ever going to carry anything more?
Hurry up, Jim. We'll be late if you don't hurry.
This ought to be a good spot for our broadcast.
Yes, lots of shoppers are sure to go by here.
What are your questions about tonight?
We thought it would be interesting to see what people think about the source of Christmas custom. Are you ready to start? Ladies and gentlemen, this is WVO's Man on the Street. What a busy Christmas season this is. Shoppers, little bundles, decorations in the windows, and along the street. Colored lights overhead, and carolers providing music occasionally. Our broadcast tonight deals with the spirit of Christmas. Here's the shopper. Good evening, sir. Your name? This is WVO's Man on the Street broadcast. May we have a few words with you?
Broadcast? I don't know.
Step closer to the microphone, sir. Your name?
George Wilson.
Mr. Wilson, we're asking people what they think about the source of Christmas custom. Can you tell us how we happen to have Christmas trees?
Let's see now.
Where were trees first used for Christmas?
It was in Germany. I remember reading that Martin Luther was the first to decorate a tree. One night he saw stars through a tree, and that inspired him to bring a tree into his house and decorate it for his children. Of course, that's just a legend according to the article I read in the magazine.
Yes, Mr. Wilson, the first record we have of a decorated tree was in Germany, about 1605. Thank you. Now your name, please.
Mrs. Henry Moore.
How do you do, Miss Moore? Will you answer a question on Christmas custom?
I'll try.
Thanks. Can you tell us why greens are used so much for Christmas decorating?
Let me think. Haven't people down through history used growing things to decorate?
Yes, Miss Moore. You're right also. There was a belief that trees and flowers blossomed at Christmas time. Thank you. Who's next?
I am. I'm Adele West.
Hello, young lady. Here's a question about presents. Can you tell us how we started giving gifts at Christmas time, Adele?
Yes, our teacher told us that the other day. She said that the ancient Romans had a custom of giving presents before the beginning of the year, and from that came our custom of giving Christmas gifts.
Good for you, Adele. The wise men gave gifts to the child, and that helped establish the custom also. Dad, who's next?
Bill White.
Our question for you, Mr. White, is why do we use holly at Christmas time?
I don't think I would have remembered if the young lady ahead of me hadn't mentioned the New Year's gifts of the Romans. They put sprigs of holly on their New Year's gifts, I understand.
Right you are. Now I think I have one to stump the expert. Will you try the hard one, Miss?
Miss Dan,
have you any idea how Miss Pye came to be part of the traditional Christmas feast?
That's a hard one. No, I'm afraid I haven't.
Perhaps it wasn't fair to ask what I thought our audience would like to hear the answer. The spices and citrus fruit of the mincemeat were used to symbolize the wise men of the East. To make up for asking such a hard one, I think I'll just ask the volunteers to tell anything they know about Christmas customs. Thank you for being on the broadcast, Ms. Stanton. Here's a volunteer. Your name?
Susan Rankin.
Miss Rankin, what do you wish to tell us about a Christmas custom?
This isn't a custom, but an interesting fact. The Puritan
Puritans once passed a law celebrating Christmas. Any Puritan who did was fined 5 shillings.
Isn't that surprising? But in fairness to the Puritans, let's remember that they wanted to keep the birthday of Christ a holy day, not one of feasting and merrymaking. Ah, who are these folks? Are you the carolers we heard in the distance?
Yes, we are.
Since the singing of carols is one of our most loved customs, I wonder if you sing one for our broadcast.
Merry Christmas. That concludes our program for this afternoon. We'd like to thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to come and witness this occasion. We'd like to give a special thank you to our two guest singers, Mr. Glover and Mr. Watson, for participating.